All right, y'all already know what it is. It's your man, Kurt, Triad Hip Hop Podcast. Getting ready to bring you another lyrical breakdown. We got to represent for my man, my brother, DMX. Rest in peace. You know, I've done one on him in the past, but definitely got to represent for him again. With the untimely passing, you know what I mean? So without further ado, let's get right into it. Okay, so this song is from a joint that DMX did back in the early 2000s. This was off of Jadakiss's first album. And this is a song called Uh-Huh. Basically, this was kind of a battle record. You know what I mean? They was going at some people, trying to take some people's heads off. You know what I mean? Now, I think for Jadakiss, it was a little more personal, but for DMX, was it just hip-hop, you know what I mean? Just like, you know, I'm trying to go for that number one spot. So, basically, Jadakiss was going at Beanie Siegel because Beanie Siegel had came out of left field and threw some shots at him. So, Jadakiss was like, oh, shit, what the fuck? And then DMX was going at Jay-Z, you know what I mean? But, you know, DMX and Jay-Z have a long history of you know, going at each other. They actually had an official battle back in the day. We talked about it on the podcast. But anyways, you know, this is a song that they call Uh-Huh. Now, Jadakiss actually, he threw a slight bar at Jay-Z too. You know what I mean? Because Jay-Z so supposedly has said some slick shit about him. You know what I mean? I didn't hear it, but supposedly Jay-Z had said some shit and then came back and sent him an apology on his two-way, you know what I mean, his two-way pager. That's what we used to roll with back in the days, you know, the two ways. We're going to get right into it. We're just going to do DMX's verse, and DMX goes hard straight out the gate. You know what I mean? I don't think it's possible for DMX to have a verse where he doesn't go hard. If my man goes hard when he's doing Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, it's impossible for him not to go hard. You know what I mean? So, without further ado, here's DMX. Uh-huh.
Here we go again. Whoa.
Kiss.
What up, dog?
These niggas running right here like they're controlling this shit.
No doubt.
Let's show these niggas how to take hold of this shit.
That's what I'm talking about,
baby. For real, baby.
Let's get it on.
I only gave you the crown so I could shoot it off your fucking head. Y'all niggas fucking dead. You heard what the fuck I said. I talk shit cause I walk shit, start shit. New York shit, the hawk shit, spark shit. The dark shit, and it been that way. Fuck how a nigga live, let's go in that way. Niggas is part of a game that I don't play. Never catch dog carrying what I don't weigh. That's 345, 138, 173 pounds straight out the gate. I don't hate, got no beef, but knock a nigga off quick. And I'm mad like a bitch at a nigga with a soft dick. Get off this, fucking with X. What on some other shit? Why the fuck you fucking with X? You must be fucking with X. Gone, catch a chicken. Fucking with me, you gone, catch a whipping.
Here we go again.
Come on now, you heard it. My man went straight off the gate chopping heads off. You know what I mean? Earl Simmons is not to be fucked with. So, like I said, this verse was going at Jay-Z, but, you know, more of a just a friendly competition. It wasn't no real beef, like they hated each other. It was just they were both real competitive, and they were both coming up around the same time. You know what I mean? Jay-Z had a little bit of a head start coming out with Jazz-O in the late 80s, and then DMX came out. DMX started really hitting the scene somewhere around 91, I believe, and then really made it big time around 98. But, you know, DMX really started getting noticed on the 4321 LL Cool J song. So anyway, let's go ahead and jump into these lyrics, because this shit goes hard. So first of all, you hear the dialogue between Kiss and X in the beginning of the song. You know what I mean? He's like, yo, Kiss. And Kiss is like, what up, dog? And he said, these niggas running around here like they controlling this shit. Kiss said, no doubt. He said, let's show these niggas how to take hold of this shit. That's what I'm talking about, baby. He said, for real, baby, let's get it on. And then DMX comes out the gate. He's like, I only gave you the crown so I could shoot it off your fucking head. Whew. What? I mean, he right there. He like, yo, he coming out like a pit bull. You know what I mean? He representing like a real, you know what I mean? Real dog right there. You know what I mean? He like, I'm not sugarcoating this shit. You know what I mean? And like I said, this wasn't no real beef. It was just hip hop. Just two people saying we want that number one spot. And DMX is basically like, you know, yeah, you got the spot for now. You know what I mean? But I'm right behind you. You know what I mean? And I only gave you that spot just so I could come for you. You know what I mean? So I like that. He said, I only gave you the crown so I could shoot it off your fucking head. Y'all niggas fucking dead. You heard what the fuck I said. You know what I mean? He talking that shit. You know what I mean? He like, yo, if I'm going to talk my shit, I'm going to go hard. And then the next bar, he go, I talk shit because I walk shit, start shit, New York shit, the Hawk shit, spark shit. You know what I mean? If you don't know, when my man said New York shit, the Hawk shit, you know what I mean? That Hawk is that razor blade, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? Them niggas from Yonkers and up there, up in Yonkers and the New Rochelle and, you know what I mean? All up in that area, they call it the Hawk. You know what I mean? When you got that blade, you know what I mean? Trying to really cut niggas, you know what I mean? So he said, I talk shit because I walk shit, start shit, New York shit, the Hawk shit, spark shit. Then he said, the dark shit. And it been that way. Fuck how a nigga live. It's going in that way. You know what I mean? And he always got to throw something about the darkness in there. You know what I mean? That's why he said the dark shit. Because, you know, that was his thing. You know, his whole personality was, you know what I mean? I believe in God, but I walk in a dark light. You know what I mean? Not a dark light, but darkness, because my life is just real gritty and grimy. And, you know what I mean? No matter how much I believe in God, I'm going through a lot of shit. So that's why he said the dark shit, and it been that way. Fuck how a nigga live. It's going in that way. Niggas is part of a game that I don't play. Never catch dog carrying what I don't weigh. You know what I mean? So he already letting you know I'm about to go in. You know what I mean? That's why he said never catch dog carrying what I don't weigh. Then he said, that's 345s, 138, 173 pounds straight out the gate. You know what I mean? That's dope right there. So he kind of breaking it down. You know what I mean? He's saying that he weighs 173 pounds, but he breaks it down like he's talking about guns. You know what I mean? He said 345s, 138. And if you add that up, that's 173 pounds straight out the gate. I don't hate, got no beef, but knock a nigga off quick. And I'm mad like a bitch at a nigga with a soft dick. You know what I mean? Yo, that's dope right there. You know what I mean? He letting you know that's how mad I am. You know what I mean? Because you know when your woman is ready to go and you ain't, nigga, she mad as fuck. So then he said, get off this fucking with X. Put on some other shit. Why the fuck you fucking with X? You must be fucking with X, dog. Catch a chicken. Fucking with me, you gone. Catch a whipping. Yo, man, listen. And I think I might have messed that up. I'm going to repeat that just to make sure I got it right. He said, get off this fucking with X. Put on some other shit. Why the fuck you fucking with X? You must be fucking with X. Go catch a chicken. Fucking with me, you gone. Catch a whipping. So I like how he really used the term X in multiple meanings. You know what I mean? So he said, get off this fucking with X. You meaning like, you know, you don't want to start fucking with DMX. You know what I mean? He said, why the fuck you fucking with X? You know, now he goes into the question, like, Why would you even fuck with DMX? Then he said, you must be fucking with X. You know what I mean? Now he's going into, he's referring to the ecstasy. You know what I mean? He like, if you fucking with DMX, you must be on some X. You know what I mean? He said, you must be fucking with X. Go catch a chicken. Meaning, you know, go find you a girl and, you know, preoccupy yourself with that shit. Don't come for me. You know what I mean? If you want some shit to do, go catch you one of these chicken head bitches out here. You know what I mean? So he like, go catch a chicken. Fucking with me, you gone. Catch a whipping. Man, listen, that's one of my favorite verses from X. And that's when, you know, I knew it was really on, that he didn't give a fuck about who he was talking about. But that was, like I said, that was his thing. You know what I mean? Now, here's the, you know, the history, you know what I mean? Just to give you a little bit of background. Like I said, him and Jay-Z battled back in the day. And DMX felt like he won, you know, but of course Jay-Z felt like he won. And then I think a lot of the crowd just kind of called it a tie because they didn't really want to say really who won, you know what I mean? But DMX was like, nah, fuck that, I won, you know what I mean? So DMX, he would never really say directly, but you could tell he felt like, I'm going to be nice and say, yeah, you know, we both went hard and we both, you know, came out of tie, but you know what it is. You know what I mean? He would kind of give you that indication, like, you know what the fuck it is. You know what I mean? This was my battle. Now, Jay-Z never really went back at DMX on records, but he did kind of throw something at him in a roundabout way one time. And that was when, right after that, that was when Jay-Z was battling Nas and Mobb Deep. You know what I mean? So, there was a lot of people who were doing stuff that was taking shots at Jay-Z. And so if you listen to the song Takeover, that's why Jay-Z, when he was dissing Nas, he said, in the Mobb Deep, he said, and all you other cats throwing shots at Jigga, you only get half a bar. Fuck y'all niggas. And that was Jay-Z's basically response to everybody, because there was a lot of people. Like I said, in this song, Jadakiss said, he threw a little shot at Jay-Z and everybody was like, oh, okay. But that was only, you know, banter. You know, that was just the same on the DMX level. He said, don't try to apologize on your two-way. Sympathy don't amuse me. You know, basically he was saying that, you know, even though Jay-Z had said some slick shit about him, you know, you did try to apologize, but I'm not here to accept your apology. You know what I mean? But that was just, that wasn't real beef. That was just him, you know, just taking a jab at him like, you know, I'm just as dope as you are. You know what I mean? Now, if you hear in the song Takeover, Jay-Z said, I don't got a two-way, you gays. This is not beef. This is rap, homie. I ain't got a scratch on me. You know what I mean? He was basically, that was him answering the issue with Jadakiss saying that he had to apologize to him on the two-way because Nas brought it up in the battle. You know what I mean? He said, you know, he called him out for having to apologize to Kiss. So Jay-Z was like, I don't even got a two-way, you know, like saying, that's not me. You, whatever you thinking about wasn't really me. So anyway, you know, that, so that was history where people were just taking shots at Jay-Z. You know, you had Jadakiss, you had DMX throwing shots at him. You had a dude named J.O. Felony who threw shots at him that around that same time. You know what I mean? It was a lot going on, you know, and a couple other people, I believe, as well. So that's why Jay-Z was like, I'ma address whoever I want to address, but the rest of y'all, fuck y'all niggas. You know what I mean? So, you know, that was dope right there. So anyway, man, but the song, that's off of Jadakiss's first album, Kiss the Game Goodbye. And that was when Jadakiss was at the top of his game. He always been at the top of his game, but that was when he really just kind of took over the game. Rough Riders as a group, as a clique, as an organization, they were just coming out of left field, just kind of taking over the game in the early 2000s. So DMX, Jadakiss, The Lox, Eve, Dragon, all of them, man, it was just killing the game. So anyway, go back and check out that song. You know what I mean? The whole song is basically a diss track. Like I said, Jadakiss did throw a shot at Jay-Z, but he was mostly going at Beanie Siegel. because Beans had threw some shots at him. And DMX, you know, just threw a couple of shots at Jay-Z, just like, you know, just to let you know, I'm still doper than you, even though you might be considered the number one spot right now. I'm still doper than you, you know what I mean? So I always liked that about DMX. He didn't care what it was, you know what I mean? He represented real hip-hop in that competitive spirit without really making it a real beef or whatever, you know what I mean? So anyway, that is my rant. Y'all already know what it is. Don't forget, hit all the like buttons, follows, subscribe, share, all of that. You know what I mean? If you're really repping for hip-hop, let us know what you think. Leave some comments, you know what I mean? Hit all those buttons, and we'll see y'all on the next Lyrical Breakdown. This is your man, Kurt, for Triad Hip-Hop Podcast. We'll see y'all soon. Peace.